Hello, and welcome to Sarah's Baked Goods. Today we're going to be making halka, which is Polish egg bread. This is a fun bread because we're going to braid it up and make a cool design. And we're also going to top it with some streusel to make it into a dessert bread. So, let's get into it.
We're going to start by making the streusel first. All you need for streusel is sugar, butter, and flour. Depending on what kind of streusel you like, technically all you do need is butter and flour, but you just need that tiny bit of sweetness to go really well with this bread. Make sure your butter is nice and cold. And mix your sugar and flour in. Once you get those three ingredients together, you're just going to rub them in. The reason why you're doing this first is you want to be putting this in the fridge so that it's nice and cold for when you are topping your bread. And it's very nice to make a whole bunch of streusel, put it in your fridge for whenever you need it. Streusel won't go bad very quickly. You could use this streusel for probably two weeks. Because remember, everything will be killed in the oven, so you don't have to worry about anything like that. And streusel doesn't mold very quickly, so you won't need to worry about that either. You want to get to medium chunks, or a nice mealy consistency. You don't want big chunks like this, you want to have littler chunks like this. And you can just rub together like this. Use your fingertips so you don't melt the butter while doing this. And there we are. Nice streusel. I'll just put this in the fridge and start on the bread. Now onto the bread. We'll mix our yeast and flour together first. Now for the yeast. Once you have the yeast in, you can mix it all about. Then we're gonna set up our liquids. So this is the main liquid that's gonna go in just to get the yeast started. And then we're gonna put the eggs with milk and salt and the butter in last. Eggs have fat and butter has fat, which kills yeast. And also the salt will be in here, which also kills yeast. So we're gonna put the sugar and most of the milk in first to get that yeast alive and working hard. And then after it's formed a semi-dough, we'll add in everything else. And by then, the yeast will be strong enough to not be totally killed. So first, we're gonna mix our sugar with our milk. Then we're gonna mix our salt and our eggs in here. This is just 100 mils of milk, and the rest of the milk is with the sugar. You just need a tiny bit of milk so that the eggs don't get curdled from the salt. There we are. Then our eggs. Make sure to give your liquids a good stir to make sure everything is dissolved in. And there we are. We're just gonna mix our milk and sugar. Make sure you get all of it in. If your milk is cold, the sugar won't really dissolve in, but as long as it's semi-dissolved, it will work a lot better. Just make sure that you get it all in so that you get the correct amount of sugar. We'll start this on low, just to form a dough. Once it's formed a dough, we'll add in our other ingredients. It's now starting to form a dough, so we'll add in our eggs, salt, and the rest of our milk. Make sure you scrape all that in. And we'll also add our butter. Make sure that your butter is not hot, it's just warm and fully melted. If it goes in hot, you can scramble your eggs and kill the yeast. So just make sure that it's not piping hot and it's just melted. We'll just mix this on low till it forms a full dough and then turn it up to medium speed to finish the dough. Once it gets to this stage, you turn it up to medium speed and let it go for, depending on how fast you're going and how strong your machine is, anywhere between 8 to 12 minutes. Here's how your dough is going to look after those 12 minutes. Just scrape it off your hook. And if you're doing it by hand, this could take a while, but just be patient. Work on it until it starts to bounce back at you. It's going to look a bit strange in there because this is a very wet dough. But when I take this out and show you, you're going to see that it bounces back at me. So this is just for showing. Normally I would just cover this and leave it to the side, but I want to show you that it's nice and bouncy. With using your dough hook, forming it back into a dough, you can start to see it's going to always be soft, but you can start to see that it bounces back at you. So once you get to this stage, put it back into your bowl. Again, normally I don't take this out, so please don't take your dough out of your bowl if you're using a mixer. That was just to show you that what it's going to look like when it's ready. So we're just going to cover this with a damp towel and let it double in size. This will depend on how warm your milk was, how hot your butter was, etc., etc. So just make sure that it's doubled in size before you start working with it again. Now that we've had it double in size, we're just gonna punch it down. Some flour on it. There we are. Now let's weigh it out. ~1800 divided by 12 is 150. So we need to get 150 gram pieces. Great way to start. Cut it in half. Cut it in half. And this should be 3. Now once you have your 12 pieces, if you want to make sure you get the correct size pieces, make an S shape and cut on the sides. Still might get weird pieces, but that should be fine. We're going to cut them into 3 so that we can make braids out of them. Once you've cut them, leave them off to the side and cover them with your damp towel. Once you get to this stage, take one out at a time, separate them into their 3 pieces. I'm gonna have to move this. So separate them into their three pieces, roll them out. Once you get to the length that you're happy with, which is should be around here, if you go any thicker than this, the inside might not bake fully, and compared to the outside might burn by the time the inside cooks, so don't go any thicker than this. And to start your braid, just go outside in, outside in, outside in, till you get to the end. Form it all into itself, flip this over, and repeat, inside out, or sorry, outside in. Make sure that this is the bottom, so you get a nice little braid like this. We're gonna put it all on our tray, and then cover it while we wait with a damp towel. Once you get to this stage, you're gonna just let it proof one last time before putting it in the oven. So cover it with your damp towel. To put the streusel on, you're going to egg wash first and then sprinkle the streusel. But we're gonna do that right before we put it in the oven. So once these are proofed, we'll egg wash, sprinkle some streusel, put them in. Make sure you have your egg wash ready so you're not rushing to get that and messing anything up. So we'll come back when these are done proofing. Once they've doubled in size, you can now egg wash them and put the streusel on. Make sure your butts aren't exploding outwards and that they look nice. If you notice that some are too close together, just move them a tiny bit so that they don't become one dough. Then simply just sprinkle over top. The egg wash will make your bread nice and dark, and it'll help stick the streusel. You have tons of streusel with this recipe, so don't be shy to put a lot on each one. And we'll just put this in the oven and come back when they're done. Here's how they turned out. They got a beautiful shine from that egg wash. That streusel is nicely encased inside the bread. It's looking good. When you start to see this dark brown color, that's when you know it's done cooking. For these ones that are a bit thicker on the sides, that's when those ones will be done. So anyone smaller than that, like this one, will definitely be done when this one is done. It's going to take about 20 to 30 minutes depending on your oven. Make sure you figure out how your oven works. For example, me today, I have one rack that gets a lot hotter than the other. So halfway through, I switched them on the racks. I did 12 minutes, switched them, 12 minutes, and it ended up being perfect. I'm just gonna set up now to eat so I can give you my feedback. Here it is. Nice and fluffy on the inside. Not too sweet, perfect. That streusel on top gives you that perfect flavor. It's got a nice crust, looking nice and shiny. Overall, this is amazing, and it's so versatile. You can make buns out of this and put cream cheese or lemon curd. You can fill this with so many different things, and it has a nice shape while it's braided. It looks really nice. And this is a nice light dessert where if you had a cheesecake or something like that, it's very heavy. And this is a lot more healthy as well. Really delicious.
If you've liked this video, please like and subscribe. You can follow me on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. I even have my own website. Thank you, and have a nice day.